guys. Yeah, some people just dropped a bunch of fish in the water. So today I have a water trapdoor instead of ice. I made it with a little bit of help from Shadow and Mini, but well, not too much. Yeah. This is what it does, so it's a nice trapdoor in the water. And it's not entirely seamless, of course, but no redstone visible anyways, and that made it a little bit harder to not have any repeaters or redstone visible, because we needed to do some tricky things now. And I also made it so all of these four blocks are in sync. That made it a bit harder as well, but yes, it closes up again, of course, as well. And then you can just hop in. So yeah. So here is the wiring and the redstone block again as well. So yes, I will just show you it, and then I will explain it a little bit. The opening and now the closing. So yes, it only uses one flip flop, and that's for the pushing upwards part. And yes, I will just explain it a little bit. First of all, to get these four in sync, what I said, it was a little bit hard because the power came from here, and I need to power this point with one tick pulse, and this point with only a one white, yes, row basically, because I had a little circuit here already. So what I did was sent a two tick pulse through here, bounce the piston, and because the piston has a two tick extension time and instant retraction, it made it so it was a one tick pulse here again and powers this. And for this part, it powers the piston and extends the block, but this signal only gets here at the moment when one tick before this piston is going to retract again. So that made it still a one tick pulse, but at the right moment, so it arrives at the same time as here. So that was pretty neat, I think. Then just the layout is pretty interesting in my opinion. So we basically have is the four pistons. Then to push the center up, because it needs to remove the water as well, we push with this piston a block plus the piston itself outwards. So that means we can power it through the block, because we didn't really have another way to power it. And it's turned to 40 blocks apparently. It's 6 by 10, right, by 3. So I don't know how it's 240, but I believe it's 108 blocks, which isn't that bad. And maybe it's 240. Oh, he counts that part. Okay, I don't. That explains something. Well, so sorry for that. Just for the wiring again. So we figured out that part, which was pretty hard. But it's pretty easy in the end, pretty neat. So then this part pushes the back outwards, so it's they are like they are now again. And then we need to pull the block back from this height. So then we extend this piston down here. And to power that was pretty tricky as well, because if you power this block, it will power this part as well. So what we did in the end is just pull back one of the pistons. So first of all, this torch got depowered. 2 ticks later it will power this spot here. So that means if it re-extends, that takes 2 ticks, and this torch takes 1 tick, so that's 3 ticks, and this is off after 2 ticks already, so it won't interfere with extension or retraction. And basically after that 4 ticks, it would power this, so it gives a 1 tick pulse to this bottom piston. And after that, after another 2 ticks, it will even extend this one as well. So then basically if the block is here, it will push it outwards to that side. And for the closing, yes, the only part we don't do is this part where it fires upwards. So then it will just retract all of these blocks back down. And the first thing it does is power this piston, so it will basically put all the blocks in this state, so this is closed already, the block itself, and then powers all of these. So then only if we fire this little circuit again, which gives this one tick pulse, it will get back up here. So yeah, now you know that. You can take another look at it to yeah, just see what I just told you. So there and there. So because we need it for the opening, we need this little circuit and we don't need it for closing, it makes that this block gets pushed up a little bit slow, but when it closes. But well, I don't think it's too bad. And I just love the system itself. It's pretty smart and it looks pretty cool. So yeah, just tell me if you want a tutorial, but I thought this was pretty pointless, but a cool technique. So yeah, I see you all later. Bye.